Like a mighty sea, like a healing stream.
Good morning. Well, good morning. Welcome to the home of the Calgary Unitarians. Whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you are on your journey of faith and search for meaning, welcome. If you're visiting for the first time or the first time in a long time, know that we are grateful to have you with us. We come together in beloved community to grow in wisdom, welcome, and deepen relationships and act for a just and sustainable world. My name is Lilias Cowper, and I use the pronouns she and her. This congregation is special to me because I feel like I belong and am accepted. This congregation is a place where I find sanctuary, wisdom, and hope. If you are here in person, please stay for our potluck today. If you are joining us online, please stay on after the service for a virtual coffee hour. Now, wherever you are, let us remember and acknowledge the traditional territories and languages of all whose ancestors were here before us. We recognize our responsibility to be stewards of this land and acknowledge that we do so in cooperation with the people of the Blackfoot Confederacy of Southern Alberta, surprised of the Siksika, Piikani, and Kainai First Nations, as well as the Dene First Nation Band, Tsuut'ina, and the Nakota First Nation, also known as Stoney. Alberta's Nakota First Nation is comprised of three bands, Bearspaw, Chiniki, and Wesley. Mukinsis, the Blackfoot word for what is now known as the city of Calgary, is also home to Métis Nation of Alberta, Region 3. In offering a land acknowledgement, we honor those who have been here, our stewards, and accept our shared responsibility for being good caretakers. We acknowledge that Treaty 7, signed September 22, 1877, was entered in as a collaboration between settlers and Indigenous peoples, making us all treaty people.
Good morning. Hi, everyone. It is so good to see you this Sunday, our in-gathering Sunday, the first of our church season. I'm the Reverend Shelley Thompson. My pronouns are she and her, and I am privileged to be the interim minister here at Calgary Unitarians. We'd like to take this opportunity to say hello to one another, and I invite you to rise and by your spirit and turn around and wave at all our dear friends on Zoom. We think Jane Perry's out there somewhere. Jane, we love you. Hi, all of our friends. Hi, everybody. Good morning. Say hi to your neighbors here in the hall. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We're delighted to be together. It's been a while since we've had this kind of gathering together. I'm so happy to see so many of your beautiful faces here. This is exciting. Well, my first exciting order of business is I get to introduce you to Christian Power. You've noticed by the sitting over here at the piano playing, he is our new interim music director, very talented. He's a vocalist, he's a clarinetist, he plays the piano and a bunch of other stuff, I think, too. And he's a teacher and he works with schools teaching clarinet clinics with the bands, and just an extraordinary all-around musician. His wife is also a musician, she's a percussionist. So they're a musical family, and we, Brandis and Mitch, are the geniuses who did our amazing search process for us. And sadly, they are both away today. Mitch and Duff are off enjoying Scotland, and Brandis is home with some sore leg situation. So on their behalf, I am delighted to introduce you to Christian, and we're having a potluck in his honor. The choir has brought potluck for us. Thank you, choir. And so please stay for lunch and get to know Christian. We're so excited. I think I'm the most excited, I get to claim, because I have a musical worship partner once again. So we're all so pleased you're here. Welcome. And then good news from Marsha Hogue that we have our refugee sponsorship committee is sponsoring a Syrian family that's coming. And they're going to be here on the 22nd, and they need beds. They need a bed for the parents, a queen size preferably. And they have a small child that needs a twin bed, and then they could use a sofa and some blankets and some sheets and pillows. And so Marsha's here today, and we have her info if you need it. Please let her know ASAP so that we can make sure that we're as ready as possible to receive them warmly and make them feel really welcome. Thank you, Marsha, for taking care of that. And then our Committee on Shared Ministry, affectionately known as COSM, is going to be presenting the results of that congregational survey we did last winter, you may remember. And that's going to lead into a good discussion about what in the world is this shared ministry and where are we going with this. So next Sunday, we also want you to bring some food that works for you. We know we all have different needs. And please bring some to share if you're able. And we will listen to COSM and participate in that very thought-provoking discernment time with them about what is going on with all of our shared ministry these days. So that's an important Sunday next week. And Leslie Robinson is here. We're very lucky to have Leslie. She's going to come up. Yes. And we have some very exciting news for you. We are having a congregational retreat on November 19th from 9 to 5 at Spiritwood. And Lilius Cowper, our vice president of our board, is our arranger, and Leslie is our fabulous facilitator. And so Leslie's going to tell us a little bit about what you can expect if you are one of the lucky people and you're all invited. Please come to our retreat.
So welcome. And it's
your rock star.
Oh, rock star. All right. It's just really an honor and a pleasure to be with you today. We've been talking about this retreat to re-energize and revitalize our congregation. There's been so much that's happened over the last few years with Deborah leaving, Shelley coming, a pandemic, online, and so it goes. And so it's a time for us to come back together in a most meaningful kind of a way before Shelley leaves and the new minister comes. So we are really in the midst of a huge transition and really wanted to acknowledge that for every one of us. And so we've got a date planned in November. It is a full day event. And what we will do is we will just re-envision not the big future, just the short future until the new minister comes. And then we'll get some, and we'll, it'll be very playful. We'll be laughing a lot. We'll be sharing stories. It will be very upbeat. And Lilius is going to tell us about where it's going to be. And it has its own magic. We, just the three of us, were there the other day. So this is a warm welcome to please come. You know, if you feel called to just be part of whatever this next bit is for us, this is the opportunity to come and play and make real positive change.
It's being held at Spiritwood. It's a retreat center that is right near Pritis. And it's a beautiful setting and a beautiful building. It has a capacity of 25, but we're hoping as many as 25 people come. The setting is very woodsy and just very nature and, you know, with nature, very tranquil. There's a creek, there's a labyrinth, and just the building is set up for retreats. So anyway, I hope as many of you can come as want to come, and I think that's it for, oh, the other thing I wanted to say is it's only about 20 minutes out of downtown or out of Calgary because of the new ring road makes it really fast to get there. But we definitely want to carpool, you know, just so nobody gets lost or anything like that. So whoever wants to, you know, come to the retreat, let us know, and we'll definitely pull people together. So nobody has to be alone in the car and kind of wander around the country roads. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So please save the date, 20th of November.
The 19th.
Oh, sorry.
19th.
19th. It is on the 19th of November.
Yes. Thank you. You can tell we're very excited about this. We spent time out there the other day, and it's just so uplifting and renewing and peaceful, and it just makes you happy. So, and if it turns out we have just, you can all come, which we would be delighted. What we'll do is we will just schedule a second day. So we'll do the same thing 2 days in a row to make sure that everybody gets to come and have that wonderful experience. And that would be our dream come true. So we will put information in your e-news and there'll be a registration link. And we'd like to hear from you if you're able to commit to that, because it's going to be an exceptional day. And it's so important to our community, our Committee on Shared Mystery, our search team, all of our transitions team, everyone who's working to really solidify who are we as Calgary Unitarians and where are we going, and what kind of minister do you want for this next part of your journey, and honor all of the tremendous hard work and endurance that you've put in already, and that we still do want to make it fun and energizing and very purposeful going forward. Thank you. We're going to light our chalice with the words, "The Spirit of Water" by Katie Gelfland. Flaming chalice is the symbol of our liberal religious heritage. We light this chalice as a symbol of reunion. We reunite in this sanctuary to share the flow of our hearts with one another. We gather together in ritual to celebrate our fountains of joy, to hold each other through storms of grief, to guide one another through rapids of transformation, to rest together in ponds of stillness. Together, we honor the spirit of water, its many forms, and its life-giving essence. Let us worship together. And please rise in body or spirit and join us in singing, "Enter, Rejoice, and Come In."
Open your ears to the song. Open your ears to the song. And it will be a joyful day. Open, rejoice, and come in. Open your hearts, everyone. Open your hearts, everyone. Today will be a joyful day. Open, rejoice, and come in. Don't be afraid of some change. Don't be afraid of some change. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Enter, rejoice, and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice, and come in.
Thank you, Christian. And it's story time with Sheila. Hooray!
Already. Excellent. It's so good to see all of you this morning. Many of you know me. I'm Sheila McMaster, Director of Religious Education, or DRE Sheila. Some of you like to call me for short. My pronouns are she and her, and I'm so happy to see all of you as we're back from summer. So nice. And this morning we're talking about, we've got water communion going on, and we're talking about belonging. And so I have a great quote from, sorry, is where I got to make sure my hair is not in the way. All right, there we go. I got a great quote from Brené Brown about belonging. It says, "A deep sense of love and belonging is a need of all people. We are biologically, cognitively, physically, and spiritually wired to love, to be loved, and to belong. And when those needs are not met, we don't function as we're meant to. We break and we fall apart and we numb and we ache and we hurt other people and we get sick." And so that's why belonging is so important for all of us. And so today I've got a simple book. It's actually a board book for toddlers about belonging. And because to me, it breaks down to a very simple level of what it means to belong. And as we go through it, as we go through each page, you might say, oh, that's true for me, or that's not true for me, but it's what each of us might wish for. And it might be kind of a guidebook back to finding belonging. And the book is called I Belong by Sherry Miners. No one looks or thinks like I do. I am glad to be me. My family likes me the way I am, and I have a place that I always belong. People in my family listen and help me. And even when I make mistakes, my family loves me and I feel safe. I belong with my friends too. There's a place for me to fit in. Everyone wants to feel welcome, and there's room for each of us. And we join together when we talk and we play and we share. And we feel like we belong when we take care of each other and stick together. And I feel needed when I play a part. And when we work together, we can do special things. And belonging feels so good that I want to help others feel good. The end. And so today, to help the kids feel like they have a sense of belonging, we're going to be doing a handprint art. So we're going to trace their hands, and they'll put their names on them, and we'll decorate them. We're going to be making hand flowers for one of our boards downstairs so that the kids can feel like they belong to their own community and our greater Calgary Unitarian community. And then we're also going to be playing some games with both the kids and the youth, where we're going to talk about what we have in common, what we don't have in common. And we got, like, you know, the game where you're like, okay, who prefers Pepsi? This side. Who prefers Coke? Jump to this side. Who prefers mornings? Okay, that's me. Who prefers nighttime? That's the whole rest of my family. And then we'll see, what do we have in common, right? So we're going to be doing those kind of games and talking with the youth about what belonging means for them. And sometimes fitting in and belonging are two different things, right? Because fitting in is more what we do to blend with others. And true belonging is, how do we be ourselves and find those real commonalities with people? So we're going to be talking about that today. And very shortly, Reverend Shelley will be taking us through what water communion is. And so we'll have the kids stick around just for a few minutes, and I'll invite them to come up first. Once Reverend Shelley is done telling us what water communion is, and they can come up first and do their water from summer, or if they didn't bring any today, just use this pitcher and they can say a few words about what you do this summer, where did your water experiences come from, and belonging here. So we'll do that, and then just come to the back and we'll go downstairs for our fun time. And some of you might be wondering, why is belonging so important? And it's that because those who have a strong sense of love and belonging have the courage to be imperfect. And now to Reverend Shelley.
Thank
Thank you, Sheila. I love that story. And it is perfect, not just for toddlers. It's for everybody. Well, every September, most Unitarian Universalist churches in the United States and Canada start off our year with water communion ritual, the gathering of the waters, when we each bring a small amount of water to pour into our communal bowl. The element of water in all of its forms literally binds each to all in the interdependent web of creation. Our bodies are mostly made of water. We really have this water thing locked down. It's a great metaphor on so many levels. And it also symbolizes the way in which we each show up as our essential selves and join our life streams together to create a beloved community. Our faith, like water, is life-sustaining. Water Communion was created in 1980 by two Unitarian Universalist women, Carolyn McDade, who many of you know was the author of Spirit of Life, one of our favorite songs, and Lucille Shook Longview. And they were charged with creating a worship service for the Women in Religion Continental Convocation of Unitarian Universalists. Oof, we love our words. And as they shaped that service for women's empowerment, they wanted to create a new ritual that spoke to our connectedness to one another, they said, to the totality of life and to our place on this planet. They say they chose water as their symbol of empowerment. And Carolyn stated, as the ritual of pouring water into the common bowl is continued, water deepens in meaning for us, just as water deepens during its long and winding journey to the sea. And today I want to share with you a short modern reflection on the meaning of the ritual, The Gathering of the Waters, by Renee Ruchutsky. It was at a gathering of white women when this gathering of the waters first came to pass, white women in a second wave of gender self-awareness, awakening, connecting, making new meaning, shifting the old ethos. The solidarity of these white women was reflected in the waters each brought, waters that became a liquid harmony of each sweet voice and intention. Today, we gather as a community of humans in a new wave of gender and racial awareness, awakening, connecting, making new meaning, shifting the old ethos. Today, we seek more than solidarity and harmony. We seek inclusion, we seek mutuality, we seek reconciliation, we seek justice for all people. Today, may our gathering of the waters reflect the gathering of our collective courage in service to the grace and love that is promised by our liberal faith. End quote. Well, in just a moment, but not yet, we're going to start our water communion. And as Sheila stated, we invite our children with their parents to come up and do this first. And so then they can all gather at the back and Sheila will take them down to their fun activities, which I want to do later. I'm going to do a hand flower later, I promise. And when each person comes forward, we have a microphone here that is height adjustable. And you can kind of come up on the little step if you're able, just make it your own. And you can either add water that you've brought with you from home or on your travels, or if you didn't bring any today, we have plenty of water from right here at our Calgary Unitarians home that you can use. And you're invited to say your name and tell us where your water came from. And then we are talking about belonging, just like our story. We want to hear from you. How do you feel when you belong, or what does belonging mean to you? So that's our question of the day for our water communion. We'd like each for you to share your sense of belonging with us as we blend our waters. So now we do invite children and families to come on up first. And then what we'll have you do is kind of row by row, maybe line up coming up the center. And then when you're ready to go back to your seats, you can go down around the edges. That usually helps with the traffic. And we'll see if we can get this microphone going. And Sheila will be here to guide our families as well. You want to help with that microphone, Sheila?
It's
Oh,
it is tall.
Here, come on over. So what's your name?
Sky.
Hi, Sky. And Sky. Where'd you go this summer?
We went to the Bow River, and that's where my water is from.
Oh, that's amazing. So go ahead and pour it in. Thank you so much, Sky. And what do you like about coming here? Anything? Pouring water?
Mm-hmm. Pouring water. Yes.
Thank you so much, Sky. And anything you want to add about your supper?
We had traveled to Quebec, so we're bringing the spirit of the St. Lawrence as well, and our favorite lake, Lake Wabamun.
Great.
All right. Thank you so much.
I'll
move out of the way. Come on up, Leia. Oh, what's your name?
Leia.
And where's your water from?
I think this is from home, but we went to a Unitarian camp that's like 9 hours away. But we forgot to grab water from there.
Okay. Nope, that's awesome. This is Unitarian camp water.
That's right.
And is there anything you like about coming and seeing everybody? Anything that makes you help you feel belong here?
The people here are nice.
Yes. Yes, they are. They are nice. And anything to add, Michael, about this summer?
Well, yes, I'd just like to explain. We did go to the Unitarian camp in BC, which is an amazing place. Please talk to me about it because it's an isolated, amazing, amazing place. So the water is actually from home because we realized that every time we want hot water in our kitchen, it takes about 2 to 3 liters of wasted water to get hot water. So we put it in a jug and use it to water the grass and the water, put it in the bird bath. So that's the water that I poured up today.
That's awesome. That's extra Unitarian water. When we're caring for our earth. So that's great. Exactly, exactly. And I will add, I'm trying to think of what I did this summer or where I went. Look for next week. We're going to have up our Unitarian medieval camp pictures up next week. So you want to take a look at that. So I went to medieval camp. So I will imbue this pour with the river water where the lonely cows mooed behind our tents. There was those who went to camp know what I'm talking about. There was a that is where that water is from in the good time that we had. And now I'll pass the microphone back and invite other people to come up and share their summer wonder. Thank you.
I take your lantern, Sheila. Children take our flaming chalice with them when they go downstairs. All right.
This water symbolically is Puget Sound. This summer, we went to Seattle and after, 3 or 4 years, got together with family, celebrated our 50th wedding anniversary. And I should probably say my name is Eric Levitt. And this is my spouse, Marcia Hauck.
So, good morning, everyone. I'm Christopher Feetz. I had the privilege of going with a friend to the Bow Glacier, which is the glacier that feeds the lake, that feeds the river, that feeds Calgary. So this isn't from the waterfall, but it's the same water, right?
That's right. That's right. You can move the microphone as needed.
Hi, I'm Carol Yankee, and this water will symbolically be from the slough on my family farm in Saskatchewan, which was full this summer. And I spent some time there and listening to the frogs and whatnot. And belonging here gives a sense of security and stuff like that. So glad to be with you.
My name's Lynn Nugent, and the water that I'm going to pour is for our Bow River and for some of the little mountain streams where did some hiking this summer, and I had a summer of belonging. My children were all home for the month of July, and it was just absolute delight. And I've belonged here for many years, and this is my spiritual home. So.
I don't know how this works.
I'm Evan, continuing the theme of the Bow River. My partner and I just moved to Inglewood this summer, and we have a place right every morning. I can see the Bow River, and it thrills me every day. Also Lake Dauphin, which is in Manitoba, where I went this summer and visited some family, where I belong.
I'm Mariana Louise Kovar, and Lake Bonavista is so beautiful in the summer that we rarely leave in the summer. All the gardens are in bloom and the trees are beautiful. So we stayed at home, and my water this summer consisted of making sure that my two bird baths were always full and always clean. And if you have never seen a squirrel negotiate a teetery plastic bird bath to get a drink, you've really missed something.
Yeah, I'm Carl Svoboda. I will be pouring some water, symbolic water, from the Spokane River, where we had a reunion of all the cousins on my mother's side this summer. And I guess that reinforced our sense of belonging. Very nice get together.
Good morning. My name's Sean Buckley. I'm the aforementioned wife of Christian. So thank you for welcoming me to your place of worship, and also Christian to your place of worship. Christian and I visited my family in BC this summer. So while my water is borrowed from you, thank you so much. it's symbolically from the Georgia Strait.
Good morning. My name is Rebecca Mobley-Kasner, and I attend with my husband, Dean. And over this last year, I've discovered a lot about myself, including that I'm outdoorsy. What? 5 camp trips, right? I've hiked, and I recently went on a hike with Kenzie, and we collected water. And I've come to realize that I belong in this province with some of my favorite people. So.
I'm Kenzie Love, and this water is actually from the creek. It's not from the tap.
Hi, I'm Leslie. This water symbolically is from the Puntledge River on Vancouver Island. And my grandson wanted to jump off a bridge as a rite of passage for his 13 years on the planet. And I nervously went with him, and he did not. And we determined instead to he would jump off a log on the other side of the very fast moving river. And so I positioned myself to protect him. And as I did so, I slipped on the very mossy rocks in the very fast moving river and rolled and got like a holy moment. And then this little hand came and it's like, Buppy, can I help you? And there was my gawky, scrawny little guy. And I, in that moment, we looked, we made eye contact, and he stepped into his manhood. And I became the elder. And I belong here. You are one of my places, and I'm so grateful to be here. Thank you.
I'm Leslie Buckle, and my water symbolically is from Fairy Lake, which is in Huntsville, Ontario, in the Muskoka region, where our daughter and her children live. And we have now started to spend every summer, and it's wonderful. I just wanted to say that when I feel that I belong the most, it's when I'm participating in a joint effort with other people and accomplishing something, like, so it could be cabaret, or it could be a Ujamagrama sale, or it could be a potluck lunch or something, when everybody's working together. Thanks.
Hello, I'm Catherine Burwash, and this is the first summer I have stayed at home and haven't traveled anywhere. But I was thinking about water, and I tried to use my rain barrel all summer to water my plants, although of course it was a dry summer. And so I don't know where that water comes from, right? Just think about it, the rain, the river, the glaciers, all of it, we're all interconnected. But I did have visitors from Lake Okanagan. So symbolically, they're part of me, and
hi, I'm Susan Ridley, and I ended up staying at home all summer, hence the water from my own flipping tap, hoping and praying that we could finally get our COVID postponed kitchen renovation done. We're still waiting for 3 full quotes. So we're going to Toronto because I have a brother that turned 75 in November, and then his wife, my oldest brother and his wife, they all got ripped off for their 75ths because of COVID. I got ripped off because for my 65th. So we're going down there to celebrate, and hopefully it'll be a surprise for the one who turns 75 in November. Oh, and there's a cousin following January too. But my sense of belonging is that I have many senses of belongings, and I will echo Leslie, where did she go? There she is, about accomplishing something together, hence all my political activity. And I value my belonging here for the fact that there's hope in this community that is up for peace and justice and anti-poverty and all the things that we do. It just fills me with hope. And I am so glad to be part of it, because there's just so much stuff going on in the world that is very anti-hope right now. So that's why I'm here. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Sandra. And I had the privilege with an arts grant of going to the East Coast this summer, well, early summer, and dipping my toes in the Atlantic, right? Yep. but I forgot to get water there. So this is from what we call the ponds in my condo complex, which we usually just call the concrete bowls, because very often there's not water in them, especially this summer. I'm so glad to see Krishan here. And I so welcome him, because where I feel I belong best is in the choir. And we get to sing again together, and we have our first rehearsal this week. So blessings to you. And we'll be seeing you from up here, looking at all your smiling faces fairly soon. Great.
I'm Lilius. And this water will be symbolic of Kootenai Lake and Wilderness Camp. We went there as children for many years. And then even after, my mother went with my younger brothers and sisters. So we spread her ashes in Wilderness Camp this summer. So this is symbolic of that.
Hi, my name is Breton, and I think this water for me is symbolic of, I stayed home, and so I was out on a walk one day and got caught in a thunderstorm, and instead of running home to try and, you know, get dry, I just had fun in the rain. So, and for me, I think sense of belonging and community and purpose is what community means. Yeah, belonging means.
Sure. My wife already took a turn, but I can take a turn too. Hello, I'm Christian. And actually on that trip, we also visited Vancouver Island, which was extremely beautiful. We got to go to the North Island for the first time. And so it was awesome. And the ocean there was, it just smelled so good. So I'm going to pretend this smells like ocean water.
Let's see, there's a few more people floating around here. Conrad, where are you? Do you want to come up? Jim, do you want to come up? Who else is in the building who hasn't had a turn yet? Come on up.
Well, I have two sons, and my younger one got married, and I had to go to Norway. Poor me. I know, hard to take. And so my symbolic water is from a fjord in Norway. Ooh. But I also got to go to Vancouver and play in the senior nationals tennis. So the water now I pour is the sweat.
Anybody else want to come up? Okay. Well, my family hadn't seen each other in ages and ages, thanks to COVID, and we got shortchanged on so many special events, including my parents' 60th wedding anniversary. So we went to Fiji. And so I brought all these shells and some coral back to represent the ocean that I got to swim in on the other side of the world. That was really something. That made me think of water communion. And belonging for me is just that. It's spending time with loved ones. It's being with people who know you and love you anyway. They may not always understand you, but they still love you and care about you. And we can disagree and still love one another. All those good things about belonging. And I especially feel a sense of belonging with my Unitarian Universalist family, because you are really my tribe. I feel so much acceptance and love and the kindness and that commitment to being good people in the world who really care, who also are hopeful about, yep, as a matter of fact, we do make a difference. We absolutely do. And we matter to one another and we matter to this world, just as every precious person does. I am delighted to belong at Calgary Unitarians. We give ourselves a few just settling moments. Christian's going to play I've Got Peace Like a River for us. You can sing along if you like, just instrumental moments of reflection on belonging and our water communion. As a beloved community of care and concern, we hold one another in our hearts and spirits, all during the ups and downs of life's journey, those tempests and those fountains of joy. We light a candle for all of our joys, we light a candle for all of our cares, concerns, and sorrows. And we light a global candle because we know we belong to the wider community and the interdependent web of all existence. There is so much that binds us each to all. And we want to symbolize the fire of our commitment, the flames of love and hope and connection that burn brightly in each and every one of us that we send out to the world. Our dear Dorothy DeBiche, beloved member of our choir, is in hospice now, and she is accepting visitors. She says she's kind of holding court in the garden area at the hospice, and appointments are available. I've managed to fit into her schedule, and I'm going to see her soon. And she is just so grateful to receive all the love and sense of belonging and purpose that she's received from each and every one of us and from being a part of this community. It's giving her a great deal of comfort and peace during this transition. So we encourage you, if Dorothy is among your beloved, to pay her some special attention and share that love with her while she's still with us. And Catherine Burwash has been maintaining a Caring Bridge site as well, so we can get the latest updates and stay in touch with her brother, Michelle, and her daughter is with her. So she is in loving arms and a very caring place, and very grateful to receive our love and kindness at this time. And our dear Kijiji is still recovering from a broken arm that was quite an ordeal, but hopefully that's not going to prevent them from singing in choir. We'll see him soon. And our dear Jane Perry is making progress on her cancer treatment. All of her updates are on Caring Bridge. And as always, she's hopeful and optimistic and inspirational to every one of us. We love you, Jane. And we're really so pleased that this journey is, that you feel good about the journey that you're on and the care you're receiving. It's heartening to us all to know that things are moving in a positive direction for Jane. We certainly send our hearts and our prayers to all of our beloveds in the James Smith Cree Nation, where the terrible violence has ripped apart that nation's community, hoping for some kind of peace to come eventually. We want to comfort them in any way we can, sending our love to them. We honor the passing of Queen Elizabeth II, whatever you may think of her role as a woman monarch throughout the 20th century and beyond really is extraordinary. And we send our best wishes to King Charles III on his new role. And as a United States citizen, I mark today 9/11, the anniversary 21 years ago of the terror attacks in New York City that deeply affected so many people, including the Unitarian Church where I worked in Westport, Connecticut, so near to New York. There were many people who were lost on that day. And we're always mindful to be so grateful to the generous, kind people of Newfoundland for taking in so many people during that time of tumult and fear. I invite you all to come forward if you wish to light a candle of care or concern. You can grab some, borrow some fire from up here in our chalice, or we have a bowl with some pebbles if you'd like to add to our communal bowl with any of your joys and sorrows while we sing Spirit of Life. Thanks.
Thank you.
Sing it again.
Spirit of life, come unto me.
Now is the time when we honor and gratefully receive the financial support that sustains this congregation and its mission. It's through the hard work and generosity of all of you that we are able to continue to build the beloved community and widen our circles of concern. And in this technological age, there are so many ways to give. We certainly thank all of you who donate regularly through online means, and there are lots of options that will appear on our slide here momentarily for how to do that. And then there's the good old-fashioned way with the envelopes and the basket. So as we take our offering today, once again, please accept our heartfelt gratitude and love for all you do to make this possible, this fabulous belonging, this wonderful community of love and faith that we all enjoy. Our four others this month is the Urban Society for Aboriginal Youth, and their mission is to enrich the lives of all urban Indigenous youth by nurturing self-empowerment and fostering healthy collaboration and communication to ensure healthy future generations. Their program focus is combining social innovation and traditional Indigenous culture that results in unique programs that meet Indigenous youth where they're at, while encouraging positive identity and a sense of self. And they work with the youth and with Indigenous partners and elders to create that programming for themselves, which is a wonderful piece of the program that really helps contribute to its success. And they're currently offering over 30 programs through this wonderful organization. So we thank you for any and all generosity you're able to share with these wonderful community partners, as we are in a month which will conclude with our National Day for Awareness for our Orange Shirt Day for the children. We are so grateful for all we're able to give. We are grateful for the blessings of receiving that we all enjoy as members of this beloved community. Your offering will now be gratefully received. Thank you to Christian, our piano man. I love you just the way you all are. We extinguish this chalice, but not the flame of love and the spirit of belonging in our hearts that we know is all too rare in this world. We take it with us wherever we go and do our best to widen the circle of belonging. As we go from this place today, may our faith inspire us to create ever-widening circles of love and belonging, no matter where we are, no matter whom we meet. Bring them on in, welcome them, show them that we put our faith in action through our love. And now please be sure to stick around for the potluck if you're here with us, or stay online so that you can chat and get to know one another better. This is your chance to come talk with Christian, the first opportunity of many. And we are delighted to have such a wonderful group here today. It's been such a pleasure to worship together and to welcome in this new year. Please rise in by your spirit and join me in singing Blue Boat Home.
Though below me I feel no motion, standing on these mountains and plains, far away from the rolling ocean, still my dry land heart can say, I've been sailing all my life. Universe is the ocean I travel, and the earth is my blue boat. Travel, and the earth is my blue bone.